My name is Riley Cote, originally from Winnipeg, Manitoba, currently living in Allentown, Pennsylvania, and in my previous life I was a professional hockey player. Becoming a professional hockey player goes back to 2001 when I adopted the enforcer role within the hockey game. I realized the guys that were getting called up were the guys lots of goals and lots of penalty minutes, and I decided to attempt being a slugger. I had over 250 professional hockey fights. I think it was 73 in the NHL. Well, I've had four diagnosed concussions within my pro hockey career, but certainly there was plenty more that were undiagnosed. I first started noticing mental health issues probably in my early 20s, my first year of pro, honestly, in the Central Hockey League, when I was introduced to this prescription drug world. I realized that the party started to just escalate. You know, the nights were later, the alcohol turned into other party drug habits, you know, lack of rest, and I didn't really identify with it as a substance abuse problem in that moment, but I knew there was something not right. Well, you know, the correlation between the concussions and my mental health was obviously that it impacted my mental health in a negative way. It was hard for me to separate whether it was the substance abuse or the repeated head trauma. You know, I think it's, you know, a little bit of both. I couldn't really separate the two, but certainly getting punched in the face for a living doesn't help mental health. It just wasn't sitting well with me. I was in and out of the lineup. You know, I feel like as a role player, your identity is this enforcer that's supposed to go take care of business. But when you're not in the lineup all the time and you're in and out and you're used just kind of as a piece of meat, I kind of started seeing that and I started losing respect for what I was doing. So when I retired in 2011 at the age of 28, I made a decision that I was going to be accountable for the hole that I got myself into. I'd already had a relationship with mushrooms, again, since I was 15. I ate them quite a bit, but again, very unintentionally. And then it all kind of clicked when I retired and embarked on this quest of holism, is that these were always medicines and I was always somewhat, you know, self-medicating with them, but I didn't really understand it at all. So I started using psilocybin with, you know, attention and very deliberately separating myself from the noise and the distractions, and this started having this amazing relationship with these because there was so much intention and love going into it. It just completely changed my life, you know, and it's been an amazing tool, and it is that. There's obviously a lot of work that goes along with it that we need to talk about, but the tools themselves have been extremely powerful for me. So the ceremony with the wake team was amazing. It was hard to describe because it just kind of, it really taps into that internal vibration, and certainly it's different than I'd ever experienced in my past using psilocybin with sound. It was extremely professional, well done, organized. Awake was a huge proponent to these different types of technologies that promote safety, and one was a wearable shirt that calculated heart rate and amount of breaths, and then there was a wearable technology on the head that helped calculate and quantify brain waves. If you're struggling with any sort of substance abuse disorder, brain injury, anxiety, depression, mental health issue, this plant medicine is extremely powerful and can certainly help increase your quality of life.